Hi everyone, this is Chandan and welcome to Chandan Logics. Hope all you guys are preparing well and staying safe at your home. In this video, we are going to discuss important concept from time and distance, that is boats and streams. Boats and streams concept is very important, and from this concept we get questions frequently in examination. And truly speaking, once if you know the concept of boats and streams, you can solve questions based upon boats and streams without using your pen and paper. Yes, 90% of questions you can solve without using your pen and paper once if you know the concept. So what I will do is, I am going to explain you the concept. After completion of concept, then we are going to solve few questions based upon boats and streams. I am not going to solve all the questions. I am going to solve few questions that came in various competitive exams, so that even you will get an idea how easily you can solve questions based upon boats and streams. Okay, one more important announcement. We are starting new batch for arithmetic. In this batch, I am going to teach each and every topic very clearly in detail. In this batch, we will cover 200 plus hours of video lectures, where we are going to discuss all the chapters very clearly in detail. Each and every chapter will be discussed very clearly in detail, such that a normal ordinary student also will be capable to solve any question that is going to come in any competitive exam by the end of this course. And we will provide you PDF material also after completion of every topic, and we will conduct examination also after completion of every topic. If you want, you can watch free demo videos also. And if you like this, then you can happily join this batch. And this batch is available in both mediums. It is available in complete English medium, and it is available in Telugu medium also. And course price for this batch is 999 rupees, and this batch is useful for all competitive exams, whether you write bank exam or SSC exam or railway exam or defense exam or CAT exam or CDS exam, whatever the examination may be, it is useful for all exams. Okay, and one more important notice, we are starting new batch for English new batch. This batch is taught by our expert faculty, Mithun sir is going to teach in this batch. He is expert faculty, so he will teach you completely all the topics very clearly in detail. So in this batch, we are going to cover 150 plus hours of video lectures, and in this batch also we are going to give you PDF material after completion of every topic, and we are going to conduct you examination after completion of every topic. Okay, so you can watch free demo videos also. If you like, only then you can join the course. And course price for this batch is 999 rupees. You can join this batch, and this batch is useful for bank exams, SSC exams, CDS exams, AFCAT exams. For all these examinations, this batch is useful. And we have one more batch, Zero to Hero batch, where I am going to teach arithmetic, reasoning, advanced maths. These three subjects very clearly in detail I am going to teach in this batch. And in this batch, we are going to cover very clearly from zero level to extreme high level, where we are going to cover each and every topic in detail. And if you observe, each and every topic we are going to cover almost 200 questions, 150 questions, 250 questions, 300 questions, depending upon the weightage. If a particular topic is going to have more weightage, then obviously we are going to concentrate more on that particular topic, and we will discuss more and more examples, and we are going to cover each and every example very clearly in detail, so that every student will be capable of solving questions that are going to come in any examination. So this batch is useful for all exams, CET examination, upcoming CET, for that it is useful. For bank exams, it is useful. SSC exams, it is useful. Railway exams, defense exams, CDS exams, for all these examinations, it is useful. Even this batch is available in both English medium and bilingual, that is Telugu medium also it is available. And we have one more free foundation batch. In this batch, we will not teach everything very clearly in detail, but you can come across all our faculty team, where we are going to provide you few classes on each and every subject. You can watch those videos, And if you think that faculty are very good and they can help you to crack the examination, then you can enroll for paid batches. Okay, this is like a free foundation batch. This is available in both English medium and Telugu medium. You can happily join this batch. And if you feel confident after joining this free foundation batch, then you can enroll for paid batches. Okay, if you have any doubts, you can just contact us through these numbers. Okay, you can just contact us through these numbers. If you have any doubts, definitely we are here to help you. Okay, so now we are going to solve questions based upon boats and streams. Okay, before solving the questions, first I will discuss the concept. After completion of concept, then we are going to solve questions based upon boats and streams. Okay, so few important terminologies, listen carefully, few important terminologies: speed, velocity, rate, all of them are same. Speed, velocity, rate. Sometimes in examination they will say speed of boat, sometimes they will say rate of person, sometimes they will say velocity of boat. But speed, velocity, rate, all of them are same. Same meaning. Is it clear? Next, speed of boat or man. Sometimes boat is going to travel, sometimes man is going to travel. Depending upon the question, whether it is boat or man, it doesn't matter. Okay? So whenever you come across boat or whether it is man, you will take them as same. Is it clear? Speed of boat or speed of man, we will represent it with SB. If you want, you can represent it with X also. It's up to you. There is no rule like you need to represent SB only. If you want, you can represent it as X. If you want, you can represent it as U. It's up to you. This is just for the purpose of understanding. We are representing speed of boat or speed of man as SB. Similarly, speed of stream or speed of current. Speed of stream or speed of current, we will represent it with SS. Speed of stream or speed of current means water flow speed. Water flow speed is nothing but speed of stream or speed of current, represented by SB. Okay, now these are the two important terminologies. Now observe carefully, this is very very important. Downstream or along the stream, both of them are same. Downstream or along the stream. Downstream we will represent with letter D. Sometimes instead of downstream, they will say along the stream. Downstream, along the stream, same meaning, no difference. Okay, now what is actually downstream? Look at the diagram. Here if you observe, water is flowing downwards, yes. And if you observe, boat is also traveling downwards, yes. Now this is speed of boat, so SB. This is speed of current or speed of water flow, so this is SS. Yes. Now when I say downstream, what is downstream speed? Downstream speed is nothing but as both of them are traveling in the same direction. Now here if you observe, when both of them are traveling in the same direction, when water is flowing downwards and boat is also traveling downwards, then obviously water flow will help boat to travel much faster. Yes or no? Why means water is flowing downwards and boat is also traveling in the same direction. As boat is traveling in the same direction, now what happened? Water will push the boat. As the reason water is pushing the boat, then obviously boat speed is increasing. So downstream speed is nothing but speed of boat plus speed of stream. Is that clear? This is very very important. Speed of boat plus speed of stream. Downstream speed is nothing but speed of boat plus speed of stream. Let us say instead of boat, person is swimming. If person is swimming and water is going to push, water is going to push, then obviously what happened? Person is going to swim much faster, or speed of person is going to increase. Why it is increasing means actually water is pushing him forward. As the reason water is pushing him forward, so speed is increasing. As the reason speed is increasing, so you are supposed to say downstream or along the stream as speed of boat plus speed of stream. That is nothing but addition. That's it. Whenever you are traveling in downstream, speed is going to increase, so you are supposed to add. Is that clear? You are supposed to add SB plus SS.
Now downstream or along the stream, both of them are same. One more important point, look here. Upstream or against the stream. Look here. It's very clear. Against. Against is like opposite. Yes or no? Against is opposite. So upstream is represented with letter U, and upstream or against the stream, both of them are same. Now look here, water is flowing downwards. Look, water is flowing downwards. Water is flowing downwards, but boat is trying to travel against it. As reason, boat is going to travel against it, so speed is going to decrease. Yes. Why means water is flowing downwards. Now water is going to push the boat. As reason, water is going to push the boat. Now speed of boat is going to decrease. As reason, speed of boat is going to decrease. Now upstream is nothing but speed of boat minus speed of stream. The same with respect to person also. If person is trying to swim, against the water, if the person is trying to swim against the water, as the reason water is flowing downwards, water is going to push the person back. As the reason water is pushing the person back, speed of the person is going to decrease. Yes? Now look here. This is speed of stream. This is speed of boat or speed of man. So upstream is nothing but speed of boat minus speed of stream. Is that clear? Upstream is nothing but speed of boat minus speed of stream. Okay? Speed of boat minus speed of stream, that is nothing but upstream. So two important points. Downstream speed is going to increase. So SB plus SS. Upstream speed is going to decrease. So SB minus SS. Now using these two relations, downstream is nothing but SB plus SS is nothing but downstream. SB minus SS is nothing but upstream. Okay. Now using these two relations, we are going to calculate two important relations. Observe here, two important relations. Now, when you add both this, what happened? When you are going to add both of this, SB plus SB. Now, this will be 2 times of SB. Yes? Plus SS minus SS gets cancelled. Yes or no? Down plus up. Now, this is equal to down plus up. From this we can say SB is equal to down plus up by 2, which means downstream speed plus upstream speed divided by 2. Yes or no? Downstream speed plus upstream speed divided by 2. Okay. Next, one more important relation. If you subtract these two, that is 1 minus 2. If you subtract these two, then what happens? Look here, what happened? If you subtract these two, SB minus of SB, both of them gets cancelled. SS minus of minus, it will be plus SS. SS plus SS means 2 times of SS. 2 times of SS is equal to D minus U. Yes or no? D minus U. That is downstream minus upstream. From this we can say SS is equal to downstream minus upstream by 2. Yes or no? Downstream minus upstream by 2. So D minus U, that is downstream minus upstream by 2. So these are two more important relations. Total 4 important relations. These are 2 and these are 2. So total 4 important relations. Once if you know these 4 important relations, then obviously solving questions will be very, very simple. And a basic relation between speed, distance, time, and how to convert kilometer per hour to meter per second, how to convert meter per second to kilometer per hour. So these are like sufficient. Now using this, you can solve questions based upon boats and streams very, very easily. And don't look at this formula, just know the concept. Downstream means speed is going to increase. So SB plus SS. Upstream means speed is going to decrease. So SB minus SS. If you need to calculate speed of boat or speed of person,
Speed of boat or speed of person is nothing but downstream plus upstream by 2. That's it. Speed of stream or speed of current is nothing but downstream minus upstream by 2. That's it. Look here. If you need to find speed of boat, adding by 2. If you need to find speed of current, subtracting by 2. Okay. Four important relations. Upstream means SB minus SS. Downstream means SB plus SS. If you need to find speed of boat, downstream plus upstream by 2. If you need to find speed of stream, downstream minus upstream by 2. If you know these four relations, then obviously you can solve questions very, very easily. Okay? I hope these four relations are very clear to you. Once if you know these four relations, now let us see how you can solve questions very, very easily in examination. Look at the question. A boat moves at 8 km per hour in still water. Look here. Sometimes they will say still water. Now don't get confused. Still water is nothing but normal water, or still water is nothing but where there is no water flow. If there is water flow, they will say with the stream, along the stream, or against the stream, or downstream, or upstream, they will say. But when they say still water, water speed is not counted, where water speed is going to be zero. Okay. Now this is just a speed of boat. Speed of boat is 8 km per hour. Speed of stream is 2.1 km per hour. We are supposed to find relative speed with which boat travels upstream. So we are supposed to find upstream. Upstream is nothing but speed of boat minus speed of stream. Yes. Speed of boat is how much? 8 km per hour. Speed of stream is how much? 2.1 km per hour. Yes. Now if you subtract, this is going to be how much? 5.9 km per hour. Yes. So answer for this question is 5.9 km per hour, which is option 2. Truly speaking, to solve this question, even this is not required. You just need to know upstream speed is nothing but speed of boat minus speed of stream. Once if you know that, already you have speed of boat, already you have speed of stream, just subtract. Once if you are going to subtract, you will get answer very, very easily. Yes or no? Very simple. Look at the next one. A boat moves downstream at a rate of 8 km per hour, upstream at a rate of 4 km per hour. The speed of boat in still water. So we are supposed to find speed of boat. So speed of boat is nothing but downstream plus upstream by 2. Yes or no? We already know what is downstream speed. Downstream speed is 8 km per hour. Similarly, upstream speed is 4 km per hour. So speed of boat means downstream plus upstream by 2. 8 plus 4, 12, 12 by 2. 12 by 2 means 6 km per hour. Yes, so answer for this question is 6 km per hour. So 6 km per hour, option 3 is going to be the answer. Without using pen, we can easily say the answer. We need to find speed of boat. Speed of boat is nothing but downstream plus upstream by 2. We have downstream speed, we have upstream speed. So downstream plus upstream by 2, you're going to get the answer. Sometimes they will ask a speed of stream. If they ask speed of stream, downstream minus upstream by 2. Yes, you know what is downstream, you know what is upstream. So 8 minus 4, 4, 4 by 2, 2 km per hour. Is that clear? So if they ask a speed of stream, then downstream minus upstream by 2. If they ask us to find speed of boat is nothing but downstream plus upstream by 2. Just now we have discussed. Yes or no? Next. A boat goes 40 km upstream in 8 hours and 36 km downstream in 6 hours. Speed of boat in still water. So we are supposed to know speed of boat. Speed of boat is nothing but downstream speed plus upstream speed by 2. Yes. Now we need to know what is downstream and what is upstream. Already regarding downstream, it is mentioned. Downstream speed is how much? If you observe, it is said like boat goes 40 km upstream in how many hours? 8 hours. So in upstream, it can travel 40 km in 8 hours. So speed is how much? 5 km per hour. Upstream speed is 5 km per hour. Similarly, in downstream, it can travel 36 km in how many hours? 6 hours. So downstream speed is how much? 6 km per hour. Yes.
Now you know downstream speed, you know upstream speed. So speed of boat means downstream plus upstream by 2. 6 plus 5, 11. 11 by 2. 11 by 2 means 5.5 km per hour. Yes. So answer for this question is 5.5 km per hour, which is option 2. Fraction of seconds. Actually, we don't have downstream value, upstream value directly. But indirectly it is said. In downstream, it can travel how much distance in how much time. Upstream, it can travel how much distance in how much time. It was mentioned, once if you know distance time, then obviously you can calculate speed. Once if you know speed, then automatically you can say what is the speed of boat. Just fraction of seconds. You have to remember only four formulas. Four formulas are very, very important. Whenever they ask you to say downstream, downstream means speed should be more. So SB plus SS. Upstream means speed should be less. SB minus SS. Speed of boat or speed of man. It is nothing but downstream plus upstream by 2. Speed of stream or speed of current. Downstream minus upstream by 2. These are four important formulas. Once if you know these four important formulas, you can solve questions based upon boats and streams very easily. Mostly 90% of questions, you need not use your pen paper also. Next one. A man swims downstream a distance of 15 km in 1 hour. If the speed of current is 5 km per hour, then time taken by man to swim the same distance upstream. So we are supposed to calculate time. Time taken by the man to travel the same distance upstream. While he is traveling in upstream, then what is the time taken? That is what we are supposed to find. Look here, it is said in downstream, 15 km distance he can travel in how much time? 1 hour. Which means downstream speed is 15 km per hour. Yes or no? Y means in downstream, he can travel 15 km distance in 1 hour. So downstream speed will be 15 km per hour. Downstream is nothing but SB plus SS. Yes or no? SB plus SS is 15 km per hour. In the question already said speed of current. Speed of current is 5 km per hour. Which means SS value. SS value is 5. If SS value is 5, what is SB value? SB value is nothing but difference between 15, 5. That is nothing but 10 km per hour. Yes or no? Now observe carefully. This is a speed of boat. Speed of boat is 10 km per hour. Speed of stream is 5 km per hour. Now our question is to calculate what time. Time taken to travel the same distance. Same distance means same 15 km. Same 15 km in upstream. In upstream, we know upstream is nothing but speed of boat minus speed of stream. Speed of boat is 10. Speed of stream is 5. If you take difference, difference is how much? 5. So 15 by 5. So time taken is how much? 3 hours time. Yes or no? So answer for this question is 3 hours. Very, very simple. Just here you need to find first what is speed of boat. Speed of boat is not given to us directly. It is given indirectly. Once if you know speed of boat, already you know speed of stream, then you can say what is upstream speed. Once if you know upstream speed, distance already mentioned. They are asking us to find time. So how much time means 3 hours time. Okay. Just very easily you can solve once if you can understand the question. Look at the next question. Abhi rows upstream a distance of 28 km in 4 hours. So Abhi can row upstream 28 km distance in 4 hours. And rows downstream a distance of 50 km in 2 hours. Then time taken to row a distance of 44.8 km in still water. Still water means water flow is going to be 0. Okay? Water flow is going to be 0. Then how much time he is going to take? So just I need to consider only Abhi's speed. Okay, only Abhi's speed I need to take. I should not take upstream speed or downstream speed. Okay, now look here. What is upstream speed? Upstream. In upstream, he is rowing a distance of 28 km in how many hours? 4 hours. Which means upstream speed is 7 km per hour. Yes or no? Upstream speed is 7 km per hour. Similarly, in downstream, he is rowing a distance of 50 km. 50 km distance in how many hours? 2 hours. So downstream speed is how much? Downstream speed is 25 km per hour. Yes, downstream speed is 25 km per hour. Now I need to know Abhi can row a distance of 44.8 kilometer in how much time? So I need to calculate time. Time is nothing but distance by speed. Distance is 44.8 kilometer. What about speed? Speed, you are supposed to know speed of Abhi. That is nothing but speed of boat or speed of man. So you know how to calculate speed of man. Speed of man is nothing but downstream plus upstream by 2. Downstream is 25, upstream is 7. 25 plus 7, now this is how much? 32. 32 by 2, now this is 16 kilometer per hour. Yes or no? This is 16 kilometer per hour. So once we know that speed of boat is 16 kilometer per hour, now just you have to simplify. If you simplify, what happened? 4 cancels here. How many times? 4 cancels here. 11.2 times. Yes or no? 11.2 times. 4 cancels here. How many times? 4 times. Yes. Now, if you simplify this, what happened? 4 2 times. This will be how much? 8. Yes. Again, if you observe, you're left with 3.2. Yes. 4 how many times? 4 8 times. This will be 3.2. Yes. So, time taken is going to be how much? 2.8 hours. So 2.8 hours, which is nothing but option 2. Is it clear? Very simple. You need to travel distance of 44.8 and you are supposed to travel at man's speed. So man's speed is nothing but 25 plus 7, that is 32 by 2, 16 kilometer per hour. So 4 cancels here, 11.2 times, 4 times. 4 2 times, this will be 8. 8 means you're left with again 3.2. 4 8 times, that is like 0.8 times, 3.2. So answer will be 2.8 hours. very simple. Just understanding the question is very important. Once if you're able to understand the question, then you can solve these questions very easily. Okay, and don't forget, I'm not solving all the questions based upon boats and streams. I'm solving few questions based upon boats and streams. Now, whenever you have questions based upon this type of model, what I am discussing, then you can easily solve this type of questions. And you'll have many more models in boats and streams. But the concept, whatever we have discussed, concept is same. But questions can be asked in different ways. And these type of questions, whenever you are going to come across an examination, then you have to understand the question. Once if you're able to understand the question, then you can solve it very easily. Yes or no? And one more important thing, if you like our videos, don't forget to share our videos with all your friends preparing for various competitive exams. So many of your friends, relatives, they will be preparing for many competitive exams. Yes or no? So I request each and every aspirant, whoever watching our videos, try to share our videos with as many friends as possible. Try to share in Facebook groups, WhatsApp groups, Telegram groups. Try to share with more and more number of persons. If you're going to share more and more number of persons, then obviously we will come across with more and more videos which will be helpful for you for various competitive exams. Okay, look at the next one. Time taken by a boat to travel upstream is twice the time taken by it to travel downstream. If the speed of boat in still water is 9 km per hour, find the speed of current. Look here, rate of current or speed of current, both of them are same. Already I told you. Now observe here, it is said time taken by boat to travel upstream is twice the time taken by boat to travel downstream. So regarding time, it was mentioned regarding time, downstream, upstream. Yes, downstream, upstream. Now in the question, they clearly told time taken by boat to travel upstream is twice that of time taken by to travel downstream. Let us say time taken by boat in downstream one part. If it is one part in downstream, upstream should be double of downstream. So double means it should be two parts. Yes or no? So time ratio will be 1:2. As we know, distance is constant. As distance is constant, time speed relation will be inversely proportional. Yes or no? Time ratio 1:2. Speed ratio will be 2:1. Yes or no? Speed ratio will be 2:1. Time ratio is 1:2. As distance is constant, time speed relation will be inversely proportional. As relation is inversely proportional, speed ratio will be 2:1. Now observe carefully. We already know speed of boat. Okay, we are supposed to find speed of current. Now look here, downstream means this is SB plus SS. Upstream means this is SB minus SS. Okay, now observe carefully. You already know SB plus SS value. And similarly, you already know SB minus SS value. SB plus SS value is how many parts? How many parts means 2. SB minus SS value is 1. Now observe carefully. Now what you have to do is, if you need to find relation between speed of boat, speed of stream, means apply componendo dividendo. Apply componendo dividend rule. You already know how to apply componendo dividendo rule. Yes or no? Already we have discussed in ratio proportions. Apply componendo dividend rule. So to apply componendo dividend rule, just what you have to do is, first add numerator denominator. If you add numerator denominator, SS gets cancelled. Now this will be 2 times of SB is equal to 2 plus 1 3. Similarly, subtract these two. If you subtract these two, SB gets cancelled. SS plus SS, this will be 2 times of SS. If you subtract these two, 2 minus 1, this will be 1. Yes or no? Now, if you simplify, 2 gets cancelled. Speed of boat, speed of stream. Ratio is 3:1. Which means speed of boat 3 parts, speed of stream 1 part. You already know what is speed of boat. Speed of boat is how much? Speed of boat is 9 km per hour. Which means 3 parts value is 9 km per hour. So 1 part value is 3. So we are supposed to find speed of stream or speed of current. If 1 part is 3, now 1 part will be 1 into 3, that is 3 km per hour. Yes. So answer for this question will be 3 km per hour. Yes or no? Very, very simple. And truly speaking, you need not apply componendo dividendo rule also. Yes. You need not apply this rule also. Without applying this rule, you can directly calculate the ratio. Look here, whenever you have downstream upstream ratio, and if you need to find speed of boat to speed of stream ratio, look here, this is very, very important point, direct one also. If you have downstream upstream ratio, and if you need to find speed of boat to speed of stream ratio, then instead of applying componendo dividendo, what you can do is directly add these two numbers, 2 plus 1 3. Next, subtract these numbers, 2 minus 1 1. Look here, speed of boat 3 parts, speed of stream 1 part. Same I got, speed of boat 3 parts, speed of stream 1 part. So instead of applying componendo dividendo, directly what you can do is add both the numbers, right? Subtract both the numbers and write them. So when you have downstream to upstream speed ratio, whenever you have downstream to upstream speed ratio, and if you need to find speed of boat to speed of stream ratio, then what you can do is directly add both the numbers, this is speed of boat, subtract both the numbers, this is speed of stream. Already speed of boat, it is set 9 km per hour. So 3 parts value is 9 km per hour, which means 1 part value is nothing but 3. If 1 part value is 3, speed of stream is 1 part. So 1 part means 3 km per hour. This will be your answer. Okay. Again, this calculation is not required in examination. Next one. Find the ratio between the speed of boat and stream if the boat can travel 30 km upstream in 3 hours and the same distance downstream in 2 hours. So we are supposed to find what? We are supposed to find speed of boat to speed of stream ratio we are supposed to find. Yes or no? Now regarding upstream, it is said boat can travel 30 km upstream in how much time? 3 hours. Yes. In upstream, it can travel 30 km distance. In upstream, it can travel 30 km distance in 3 hours, which means upstream speed is 10 km per hour. Yes or no? Upstream speed is 10 km per hour. Similarly, same distance in downstream. Same distance means same 30 km. In downstream, it can travel in 2 hours, which means downstream speed is 15 km per hour. Yes or no? Downstream speed is 15 km per hour. You know upstream speed, you know downstream speed. Now we are supposed to calculate speed of boat to speed of stream ratio. Speed of boat is nothing but downstream plus upstream by 2, which means 15 plus 10, 25 by 2. Yes or don't simplify, keep same as it is. Speed of stream is nothing but downstream minus upstream by 2, 15 minus 10, that is 5 by 2. Now just to simplify, if you simplify, 2 gets cancelled, 5 cancels here 5 times. 5 cancels here 1 time, which means ratio is going to be how much? Ratio is going to be 5:1. Yes or no? 5:1, that is nothing but option 1. Is it clear? Very, very simple.
Just you have to understand the question. That's it. Nothing more than that. You have to read the question carefully. Once if you're able to understand the question, it's all about solving it in fraction of seconds. Yes, you can solve this in fraction of seconds. Understand the question carefully. And you need to know the concept. Already I have told you concept earlier. Four important points. Yes or no? Upstream means speed of boat minus speed of stream. Downstream means speed of boat plus speed of stream. If you need to find speed of boat or speed of man, downstream plus upstream by 2. If you need to find speed of current or speed of stream, downstream minus upstream by 2. These four golden rules. Once if you know, then you can solve these questions very, very easily. Yes or no? Next one. The speed of a motor boat to that of current of water. Current of water is like speed of water. Ratio is 36:5. The boat goes along with the current in 5 hours 10 minutes. It will come back in. So it is saying like it will go with the current, which means downstream. Along with the current means downstream. Downstream time is 5 hours 10 minutes. Now they are asking when it is coming back. So upstream time, how much we are supposed to find? Yes or no? Now look here. Here already we know speed of boat, speed of current ratio. Speed of boat is 36 parts. Speed of stream is 5 parts. Now from this I can say downstream to upstream speed ratio. Yes or no? Downstream to upstream speed ratio. Downstream is nothing but speed of boat plus speed of stream. Speed of boat 36 parts. Speed of stream 5 parts. 36 plus 5, 41 parts. This is a downstream. Yes. Upstream is nothing but speed of boat minus speed of stream. 36 minus 5, 31 parts. Yes or no? Now observe carefully. We know distance is constant. As distance is constant, speed time relation will be inversely proportional. Yes or no? Speed time relation will be inversely proportional. If speed ratio is 41:31, time ratio will be 31:41. Yes. Why means speed time relation is inversely proportional. If speed ratio is 41:31, time ratio will be 31:41. Now if you observe in the question already it is said downstream time taken is how much? 5 hours 10 minutes. Yes or no? Downstream time is mentioned. 5 hours 10 minutes. Now 5 hours 10 minutes, if you convert in terms of minutes, it would be how much? 5 hours means 5 into 60, 300 minutes plus 10, 310 minutes, which means downstream time taken is 31 parts. Now 31 parts value is 310 minutes. Yes or no? 31 parts value is 310 minutes. So from this we can say one part value is 10 minutes. If one part value is 10 minutes, upstream time taken is 41 parts. 41 parts value will be 41 into 10. That is 410 minutes. Yes or no? Now 410 minutes means answer would be how much? If it is 420 minutes, then I can say it as 7 hours. Yes or no? Why means 760 times 420? If it is 420, it will be 7 hours. But this is 410, which means 10 minutes less than 7 hours. 10 minutes less than 7 hours means 650. That is 6 hours 50 minutes. Option 3 is going to be your answer. Yes or no? Very, very simple. Just you need to know downstream means speed of boat plus speed of stream. Upstream means speed of boat minus speed of stream. Based upon that, calculate upstream downstream speed ratio. As distance is constant, time will be inversely proportional. Already you know time taken while traveling in downstream. You are supposed to calculate time taken while upstream. Just to simplify, answer is nothing but 6 hours 50 minutes. That would be your answer, okay? If you like our video, don't forget to share our videos with as many friends as possible. And even you also, click the like button. Don't forget, okay? Look at the next question. A man rose to a place 48 kilometer distance and come back in 14 hours. He finds that he can row 4 kilometers with the stream in the same time as 3 kilometers against the stream. The rate of stream. So we are supposed to calculate speed of stream. Okay.
Now, what question is saying? Man can row a place 48 kilometer distance and come back in 14 hours, which means he will go and he will come back. Total time taken is how much? 14 hours. Let us say while going, he is going in downstream. While coming back, he should come in upstream. So time taken for downstream, upstream together is how much? Together is 14 hours. Yes. Now they said one more point. He finds that he can row 4 kilometer with the stream in the same time as 3 kilometer against. Against is like upstream. Now look here. We have downstream to upstream relation. Yes or no? We have downstream to upstream relation. Okay. Now it is said that he can row 4 kilometer with the stream. With the stream means downstream. If it is downstream, he can row 4 kilometer. In the same time means here time is going to be constant. Yes or no? Same time means time is constant. In the same time, he can row 3 kilometer against. Against means upstream. Now observe carefully. This is ratio. This is ratio for what? Distance. Yes. Distance ratio is 4:3. As time is constant in this question, distance speed relation will be directly proportional. Yes. If distance ratio is 4:3, speed ratio also will be 4:3. Why? Means time is constant, same time. So time is constant. Distance speed relation will be 4:3. Now look here. This is what? Now if you observe, this is nothing but downstream. Downstream means SB plus SS. Now this is upstream, which means SB minus SS. Now from this, can I say what is the speed of boat? What is speed of stream ratio? Yes, happily I can say. Already we have discussed similar type previously. Yes, if I need to find speed of boat, add both of this. 4 plus 3, 7. If I need to find speed of stream, 4 minus 3, 1. Yes. So speed of boat to speed of stream is nothing but 7:1. Okay. Now what we are supposed to find? We are supposed to find speed of stream. So speed of stream is one part, but our question is what is speed of stream in terms of kilometer per hour? I need to find it. Yes or no? Now look here. Man is going a distance of 48 kilometer and he is coming back. Yes or no? Which means let us say he is going downstream and while coming back, he is coming in upstream. Downstream speed is SB plus SS. Why? Means downstream speeds will be added. Upstream means SB minus SS. Just a minute. Upstream means SB minus SS. So total time taken is how much? 14 hours. Is it clear? While going, he is going in downstream. While coming back, he is coming in upstream. So downstream speed SB plus SS. Upstream speed SB minus SS. For both of them combined together, time taken is how much? 14 hours time taken. Yes or no? Now listen carefully. Our question is to find speed of stream. As our question is to find speed of stream, now we can eliminate this speed of boat. Yes or no? We can eliminate. How we can eliminate? Now if you observe here, what is relation between speed of boat, speed of stream? Speed of boat by speed of stream is equal to ratio how much? 7:1. So from this we can say speed of boat is equal to 7 times of speed of stream. Can we say this? Yes or no? As we know speed of boat is 7 times of speed of stream, replace speed of boat with speed of stream. Our requirement is speed of stream. So replace, if you replace, this will be how much? 7 times of speed of stream plus speed of stream, 8 times of speed of stream. Yes or no? So 48 divided by 8 times of speed of stream plus 48 divided by 7 minus 1. This is 6 times of speed of stream. Now time taken total is nothing but 14 hours. Now observe carefully. 48 cancels in 6. How many times? 8 times. 48 cancels in 8. How many times? 6 times. Now LCM. LCM will be how much? Speed of stream, speed of stream. LCM will be speed of stream. 6 plus 8, 14. Now this is equal to 14. Now just to simplify, 14, 14 gets cancelled. So we can say speed of stream is 1 kilometer per hour. Yes or no? So answer for this question is 1 kilometer per hour. Very, very simple. And truly speaking, these many steps also not required. This is just for the purpose of understanding. Truly speaking, without writing these steps also, you can directly get the answer.
Yes or no? Y means this is 7 plus 1, 8 parts. 7 minus 1, 6 parts. 48 divided by 8. Now this is 6. 48 divided by 6. This is 8. 8 plus 6, 14. 14, 14 gets cancelled. Finally, we are going to get speed of boat. Speed of boat is how much? Speed of boat is 1 kilometer per hour. Yes? So speed of boat will be 1 kilometer per hour. If someone asks us what is speed of stream, if speed of boat is 1 kilometer per hour, speed of stream will be 7 kilometer per hour. That's it. Yes or no? Just you have to understand the question. Understanding the question is very, very important. Once if you are able to understand the question, then you can crack any type of questions, whether it is difficult question or medium level question or easy question. You can easily crack only if you can understand the question. In competitive exams, understanding the question is very, very, very important. You have to understand the question first. Look at the next one. Speed of boat in standing water, that is like still water, is 9 km per hour. And the speed of the stream is 1.5 km per hour. A man rows to a place at a distance of 105 km and comes back to the starting point, the total time taken by him. So we are supposed to find total time taken. Now what happened? There is a place which is 105 kilometers away. Yes or no? 105 kilometers away. Now he is going and he is coming back. Yes or no? He is going and he is coming back. Now we are supposed to find what is the time taken. So we are supposed to find time. Time is nothing but distance by speed. He is traveling a distance of 105 kilometers. Yes. And again, he is coming back, which means he is traveling the same 105 kilometer. Let us say, while going, he is going at downstream. If he is going at downstream, downstream speed means SB plus SS. SB plus SS means 9 plus 1.5. This is 10.5 kilometer per hour. Yes. While coming back, he is coming at upstream. Why means? If he is going at downstream means coming back, he should come at upstream. Upstream speed will be what? Speed of boat minus speed of stream. 9 minus 1.5. Now this will be 7.5. Yes or no? Now we are supposed to calculate time. Now just to simplify it. Time is nothing but distance by speed, distance by speed. 105 cancels in 10.5. How many times? 10 times. 105 cancels in 7.5. How many times? 14 times. So 10 plus 14, time taken is how much? 24 hours. Yes or no? So answer for this question is 24 hours, which is option 4. Very, very simple. You can solve this in just a fraction of seconds. You need to know that while going, he will go in downstream. While coming back, he will come in upstream. Or else while going, he will go in upstream. While coming back, he will come in downstream. So time is nothing but distance by speed. So distance is 105 km. Downstream speed is 10.5. Distance is 105 km, upstream speed is 7.5. Just to simplify, if you simplify, answer is 24 hours. Yes or no? Look at the last question. This is a very good question and you can solve this question in just fraction of seconds. You can, if you can understand the question. On a river, F is the midpoint between two points E and G on the same bank of the river. A boat can go from E to F and come back in 12 hours, and it will go from E to G in 16 hours 40 minutes. How long would it take to go back from G to E? So we are supposed to find how long would it take to go back from G to E. Now observe carefully. Look here, this is very, very simple question. Observe carefully. Here if you observe, so it is said like F is the midpoint. So F is going to be the midpoint, it seems. F is the midpoint between the two points E and G. So this is E, this is G. So E, G are two points and F is the midpoint. Okay, F is the midpoint. It is said that a boat can go from E to F and come back in 12 hours. Now look here. It can go from E to F and it will come back. Total time taken is how much? Total time taken is 12 hours time, which means going and coming back, total time taken is 12 hours time. It is said that it will come back from E to G in 16 hours 40 minutes. It is going to come back. It will go from E to G. It will go from E to G in 16 hours 40 minutes. E to G means, observe carefully, it is going to go from E to G.
E2G, how much time? 16 hours, 40 minutes. Yes or no? 16 hours, 40 minutes. Now observe carefully. To go from E to G, 16 hours, 40 minutes means, now if you observe, E to F, this E to F is nothing but exactly half of E to G. Yes or no? Y means E to F, F to G. Now both of them combined together is nothing but E to G. Yes. Now E to G time taken is how much? 16 hours, 40 minutes. So to go from E to G, 16 hours, 40 minutes means to travel half of this, time taken will be how much? Time taken will be half of this. Half of this means 8 hours 20 minutes. Yes or no? 8 hours 20 minutes. To travel half of the distance. Which means from here to here going 8 hours 20 minutes. From here to here going 8 hours 20 minutes. Both of them combined together 16 hours 40 minutes. Yes or no? Next, observe here. It is said to go from E to F and coming back, time taken is 12 hours, which means out of these 12 hours, 8 hours 20 minutes is the purpose of going. So 8 hours 20 minutes for the purpose of going means for the purpose of coming back, it should be difference between these two. Difference between these two is how much? Difference between these two is 3 hours 40 minutes. Yes or no? Very, very important. Look here. Total time taken to travel from E to F and coming back from F to E is 12 hours time. Out of this 12 hours time, for the purpose of going from E to F, time taken is 8 hours 20 minutes, which means remaining time should be for the purpose of coming back. Out of 12 hours, if we subtract 8 hours 20 minutes, remaining balance is 3 hours 40 minutes. Yes, so to come back from F to E, 3 hours 40 minutes. Similarly, to come back from E to F also, same time. Why mean this is exactly half? If this is 3 hours 40 minutes, even this should be 3 hours 40 minutes. Yes. Now, what is our question? Our question is asking to travel from G to E backward, how much time taken? 3 hours 40 minutes, 3 hours 40 minutes. Both of them combined together, 6 hours 80 minutes. Now 6 hours 80 minutes is nothing but 7 hours 20 minutes. Yes or no? So this is going to be our answer. 7 hours 20 minutes. 7 hours 20 minutes, option 4 will be your answer. Very simple question. Truly speaking, I explained you all this just for the purpose of understanding. But in examination, you need not represent all of this. You can directly say the answer. Yes or no? Why means it is very clear that to go from E to F and coming back, time taken is 12 hours. To go from E to G, time taken is 6 hours, 16 hours, 40 minutes. Half of this will be 8 hours, 20 minutes. Out of 12 hours, if I subtract 8 hours, 20 minutes, remaining balance will be 3 hours, 40 minutes. So coming back, half of the distance, 3 hours, 40 minutes. Total distance means 3 hours 40 minutes plus 3 hours 40 minutes, that is nothing but 6 hours 80 minutes. 6 hours 80 minutes is nothing but 7 hours 20 minutes. Yes or no? So answer for this question is 7 hours 20 minutes. Is that clear? So with this, we are going to end the session. As I have already told you, if you want to join our paid courses, you can join our paid courses. And you can enroll for free demo videos. Already I have told you, free foundation batch, which is like absolutely free. You can enroll for that batch also. If after watching free demo videos, if you like the classes, then you can join paid classes. Okay. If you have any doubts, you can just call us through these numbers, or you can just download ChandraLogics app from Google Play Store. You can see all courses for different competitive exams. You can choose the course for which you are preparing. If you have any doubts, then you can call for these numbers and we are there to help you. Okay. And don't forget to share this video with as many friends as possible. So many of your friends, relatives, they may be preparing for different competitive exams. So if you forward our video, or if you are going to share our video with all your friends and family members, then this will be a booster for us. And we are going to come across with more and more good videos.
And those videos will be helpful for you to crack your examinations very easily. So I request each and every student to share our videos in Facebook groups, WhatsApp groups, Telegram groups to all your friends and family members. Meet you in the next session. Thank you. Have a nice day. Bye-bye.